In less than 20 minutes, I'll show you how to train AI models that can outperform ChatGPT, Claude, and even DeepSeek. You see, training AI models used to cost millions of dollars and require massive server farms and thousands of GPUs. OpenAI's ChatGPT 4 cost approximately $78.4 million to train. And just recently, DeepSeek spent $6 million training their new R1 model. But what if I told you that you could train powerful AI models on your personal computer in only a couple of hours and for less than $5? You see, I've spent countless hours optimizing AI training for my own uses, and I discovered something interesting. The same techniques that companies like Google, DeepSeek, and OpenAI use can be adapted for our own use cases. Now, let me show you something interesting. Most businesses think that they need ChatGPT level models with billions of parameters to get good results. But here's what's fascinating. I recently fine-tuned a 7 billion parameter model that outperformed GPT-4 in my specific use case. And it wasn't even close. You see, there's a secret that big AI companies won't tell you. And it actually explains why a model 1/100th of a size can perform better for your business or your specific use case. Let me show you the exact numbers. A recent study compared OpenAI's ChatGPT-4, Anthropic's Claude, and other large language models against smaller, fine-tuned models for specific tasks. The results were shocking. For specialized tasks, fine-tuned models outperform GPT-4 by over 50% in accuracy. Take this example from the study. When analyzing sentiment in news articles, the smaller, fine-tuned 7 billion parameter model was 92% accurate, while ChatGPT-4 and Claude were only 87% and 86% accurate. But here's where it gets really interesting. For more specialized tasks, like stance classification, the gap gets even bigger. Stance classification is when you determine if text supports or opposes a certain topic. And here are the results. The fine-tuned model, 94% accurate. ChatGPT and Claude, 58% and only 61% accurate. And here's the best part. You only need about 200 to 500 training examples to achieve these results. This means you don't need massive data sets to get better performance than ChatGPT. So why does this work? While ChatGPT 4 and Claude are trained on everything from cooking recipes to rocket science, when you fine-tune a smaller model on your specific business data, you're creating a specialist that deeply understands your exact context. Now, before I show you how to fine-tune your own model, there's something critical you need to understand about your training data. You see, most people make this mistake and it wastes hours of compute time and thousands of dollars. I discovered this the hard way when I first tried fine-tuning models for my own needs. I had all this customer data, support tickets, and sale conversations ready to go, but when I tried to train the model, it completely failed. It turns out there's a specific way you need to structure your data that most tutorials don't tell you about. It's not complicated, but if you get this wrong, your model will either fail to train or it will give you garbage results. Let me show you the exact format that consistently works. Now that you understand that bigger does not always mean better, the secret to successfully fine-tuning isn't just having data, it's how you structure it. Most people get overwhelmed thinking they need complex JSON files or special data formats. But here's what's really fascinating. Unsloth has completely simplified this process. There's just two things you need in your data. And if you get these right, you're 95% of the way there. All you need is two columns. The first column is the instruction or the input text, and the second column is the desired output. That's it. No complex formatting, no special tokens, and no JSON manipulation. You can put hundreds of these pairs in a simple CSV file with two columns. But here's where it gets interesting. The real power comes from how you phrase your instructions. Let me show you a real example for a gym AI trainer. You see, the input could be create a 30-minute workout using dumbbells, a yoga mat, resistance bands, and then focus on my upper body, and I have intermediate level experience working out. And then your output column could say, here's your 30-minute upper body workout. Warm up for 5 minutes, arm circles for 30 seconds, band pull-aparts, 2 sets of 20, light dumbbell shoulder press, 2 sets of 15. The main circuit, 20 minutes, 4 rounds, dumbbell chest press on mat, 12 reps, band rows, 15 reps, dumbbell lateral raises, 12 reps, rest 45 seconds between rounds, finisher, 5 minutes, superset, band tricep pushdowns, 15 reps, dumbbell bicep curls, 12 reps, no rest between sets, repeat until time is up. That's a perfect example of how you want to structure your data for a gym AI trainer. A second example could be a customer service response. For example, the input could be, will my brake rotor part number BR55437 fit my 2012 Toyota Corolla? The current rotor diameter is 10 inches, but I want to make sure it's compatible before ordering. Thanks, Mike. And then the output would be, hi Mike, yes, brake rotor part number BR55437 is fully compatible with your 2012 Toyota Corolla. I've checked the specs and they match perfectly. Rotor diameter is 10 inches, the bolt pattern, the center bore, and the thickness all match. One important thing to note is if you're replacing your rotors, we recommend you also inspect your brake pads if they're more than 70% worn. And that would be a perfect way to structure a customer service response. And that's it. You can put hundreds of these pairs in a simple CSV file with just two columns. The real power comes from having examples that match your brand voice and your specific use case. But here's where it gets interesting. Let me show you how to actually train a model in only a couple of hours. Now that you understand how to format your data, here's where most people get stuck: actually training the model. And what's fascinating, while most tutorials will have you spending hours setting up complex training environments, there's a way to do this in less than a couple hours using Unsloth. Let me show you the exact process that consistently works. All right, so in this example, I'm going to be making an AI workout generator. So as you can see here, I have my two columns. I have my input and I have my output. Very, very basic here. And you can just see the input is the prompt that I'm asking for, and the output is what I expect back as a result. So I'm going to switch over to the Colab notebook. Again, you can run this absolutely for free inside of Google Colab. And all I'm going to do is run you through the steps. These first cells, you do not change anything. This first one took 21 seconds. I've already done it. Again, this next one, you just choose the model that you want to use. I am using the Meta Llama 3.1 8 billion parameter model. However, you can use anything that you want out of this list. You have Gemma, you have Phi-3, and then Mistral as well. And then what you're going to do is run this next cell, which is going to add the Lora adapters so that we can update the model based on our training data. And then we're going to prep the data. Now this code here, you may actually have to change it based on how you create your file. As you noticed, I only had two columns, the instruction and the output. So what I did here was I just hard coded in the instruction, and then I'm going to use the input from my file, and the response would be the output from my file. And that's what I did here. And then you can see here, I printed out the first row, which you can see the instruction is what we have here. And then the input is right here in the instruction. I just named it instruction instead of input. I know, a little confusing. And then the output is exactly what we expected. And then I went ahead and I trained the model. Now, a couple of things I want to call out here is you probably want to comment out this max steps line depending on how many examples you have. I don't have that many examples, but you might want to train the model for longer, and if it goes over these steps, it'll cap it at 60. Also, the number of training epochs. One is a full set, so it'll go over your data one time. I set it to 2 here. You also probably want to increase the warm-up steps. I set it to 50. And on the T4, you can probably set the accumulation steps to 8 and the batch size to 2. You also might want to slow down this learning rate. The slower the learning rate, the better kind of results that you get. And then you can also choose different types of optimizations as well. I stuck with the default here. It took about 9 minutes for this to run, to train here, and you can see the results. You want to see this continue to get lower and lower, and that will mean you're getting better results. And now, finally, we can play with it. How does it work? You can see here, I just copy and pasted the exact same instruction that I had above, and then I also just gave it a prompt. Hey, give me a 30-minute workout I can do in my garage. I have a pull-up bar and dumbbells, and that is it. And then this is the output that it gave. Here's your workout: 30 toes to bar, 30 dumbbell thrusters, 30 toes to bar, 30 dumbbell thrusters, 30 toes to bar. And there you have it. That is how you can train an AI model for your own business in only a couple of hours and less than $5. It's absolutely free. If you want to upgrade the GPU that you use from Google Colab, you can do that, and that might actually cost a little money, but the T4 is absolutely free. Now, imagine having access to not just fine-tuned models, but an entire suite of AI tools that can transform your business. From customer support, to content creation, to social trend analysis, and yes, even custom AI models like the one we just built. That's exactly what I'm building. Look, AI isn't just about having the most powerful models. It's about knowing how to apply them to real business problems. And that's what makes my community different. Inside, you're going to get ready-to-use automations for content creation, learning, social media trend analysis, and more. You're also going to get early access to new AI tools and strategies before they go mainstream. And you're going to get access to me and other AI practitioners solving real business problems. I'm opening the door soon to a limited number of founding members who want to be at the forefront of AI implementation. And if that's you, I want you to join the waitlist now by clicking the link in the description below to get notified when I launch and to secure your founding member spot for the first 50 members only. The future of business is AI powered, and it's not about who has the biggest models, it's about who can implement them first. Join us at the link below and let's build that future together.